Hey everyone, I'm Summer. Welcome to my channel. A friend sent me a private message saying, "Want to know how I use the smearing tool? I want to make a video about using the smearing tool as a transition. So I'll share this video with you all. How do I use the smearing tool and the setting method of the smearing tool? Take these three colors in the picture as examples. When we usually use the smearing tool, use a normal smearing tool without making any brush settings. If you directly choose the smudge tool to paint the picture, we will find that the colors in the picture will be very stiff. It looks like the effect of a finger smear. The picture will look even more unnatural instead. Moreover, there is no fusion or transition between the colors. Such an effect is not what we want. This is even less likely to achieve our goal of improving the picture quality and enhancing efficiency. I think this is where many friends are confused. Why is the smearing tool I use different from yours? I can use the smudge tool to make a relatively soft transition of colors. The color is smooth and very natural. The color is smooth and very natural. It's not the problem of the smearing tool, but that you haven't been able to bring out its functions. Now let's take a look together at how to set up the application tool. Only in this way can there be a better and softer transition effect. Let's first take a look at the settings of my smudging tool. I want to achieve a transitional effect like mine. The spread option should be enabled in the smear tool settings. This option is very important. It is impossible to have a soft transition of colors without enabling the spread option. Enter the scatter options settings page and select this option for the two axes. Any brush can be used. I choose a paintbrush with a hard edge now. The brush only affects the texture of the picture, not the transition. Adjust a numerical percentage of the dispersion. After opening the spread, it can make the brush direction of the smudging tool spread out in all directions. It is precisely because of the scattering of the brushes that the colors have a transition. The option of brush transfer can also be enabled. After selecting the part to be transferred, check whether the pen pressure function is enabled. Although the transfer option is enabled now, but in fact, the corresponding function was not selected in the intensity section. After opening the spread, use the smear tool to make a transition. These two colors can blend together very well, so I want the coloring tool to be able to achieve a smooth blend of colors. The main control points are the scattered options. After the scatter selection is made, check the two axes. Be careful not to set the value too high. Under my normal circumstances, it will be controlled at around 50% to 60%. After adjusting it to large, due to the relatively large area of distribution, it consumes more memory. It will make the picture lag, and there will also be some brush particles remaining in the picture, especially for this kind of brush with relatively hard edges. Set the value a little lower. Even adjust it to 20% to 30%. It can also have a relatively gentle transition effect. You can try the differences between different values and choose the one that suits them. The brush of the application tool can be replaced at will, like the granular brushes we made ourselves. It can also be used as a brush for smearing tools. I'll change to a brush with particles now. Turn on the distribution option. Check the two axes. Turn on the transfer option. Use this granular brush for the transition. Then you can draw an effect with texture on the surface. If a brush with a soft edge is used, or it could be the hard edge brush that comes with paint, then a more smooth and smooth surfaced material effect can be achieved. This is up to everyone to choose based on their own picture and painting style. When using the application tool, it is still necessary to set the intensity of the application. This intensity mainly affects the application tool, the intensity of its color transition, and the range of blurring. If this intensity value is reduced, it will be applied more gently. The area to be applied will also be relatively smaller. If this intensity value is increased, the color transition will also be faster. The influence range of the paintbrush will also be larger. This value is also based on the area you want to apply. Make targeted adjustments. Under my normal circumstances, this intensity will be set relatively high. Then control the strength of the brush by the force of your hand, because the brush tool on my side has an option to enable the transfer of pen pressure. So, the influence range of the application tool can be controlled by the force of the hand. Even if the intensity value is relatively large, it doesn't have a significant impact. I'm exerting force with my hand on this side. the color transition will be relatively more solid. If your hands are gentle, the color transition will be softer. Personally, I like to set up this tool in this way. If everyone feels that the control is not very familiar, this intensity value can be slightly adjusted to be smaller. When I draw different pictures, the smearing tool will select different brushes. The most frequently seen works of mine might still be of this anime type. This kind of scene is relatively clean and tidy. The effect of the application tool I use most frequently is like this. Be able to quickly soften and transition these two colors naturally. I usually use it on the character's face, where the figure is soft and the face turns gently. When drawing the transition, I will use the hard-edged brush first. I will use the hard-edged brush first, then use the smudge tool to gently blend the colors. Like the part of the eye socket in the picture, apply it slightly gently with your hands. The edges that have been painted can be erased with a hard-edged eraser. Let's take a look at the settings of this tool. The scattered part, the two axis option is enabled. I adjusted the scattered value to 62%. Meanwhile, the brush is passed open. In the transfer options, the intensity jitter was selected as pen pressure. I didn't use a normal continuous paintbrush. Instead, use this kind of brush in the form of scattered dots. In this part, in the shape of the pen tip, I increased the spacing of the brushes. For the intensity part of the brush, I adjusted the value to 90%. This brush of the brush is a soft edge brush that comes with PS. This is the most frequently used application tool by me. Then, if a more realistic effect is drawn, if you want to have some texture and texture in the picture, use the smudge tool to select a textured brush. Whether the texture is thick or thin is up to you to choose. At the same time, spread it out. The parts of the brush spacing adjust according to the texture density you want to achieve. The strength of the application tool, it is also set according to one's own pen control habits and the strength of the hand. Pay attention when using the smearing tool. Write along the direction of the structure. When applying, be sure to draw according to the shape and structure of the object you are drawing. Otherwise, it will disrupt the original relationship of the picture. Take a look at the transition effect. Hair can also be transitioned with the application tool. Just apply it lightly and you can achieve a textured effect. There is also a transition of colors. These are the little secrets of applying tools. In summary, if you want to do the transition soft effect, the distribution option must be turned on. The settings of the brush spacing and intensity values vary from person to person. It mainly depends on what kind of effect you want in the picture, and choose based on your ability to control the brush. There is something to note: when someone is using the smearing tool, the entire software will be extremely laggy. This might be because the option of sampling all layers has been checked. It is not recommended that everyone check this option. If this option is checked, when the smudge tool is used, it samples all the layers in the picture. This will make the computer operation too slow. The more layers there are, the more operations there will be, and the more laggy it will become. Then, if the computer performance is not good, it may also crash and the files will be damaged. So be sure to pay attention. My usual habit is to place different blocks on different layers. The transitional parts that need to be done for each layer during the drawing process, just use the smudge tool to do it. Each part is done in layers, so the function of sampling all layers is not often used. This can also save some performance of the computer. This is one way to use the smearing tool. The smearing tool is actually a relatively simple, effective, and quick tool for making transitions. It will be much faster than drawing stroke by stroke with a normal paintbrush. Everyone can have a try. That's all for today's sharing. I hope everyone can feel the joy of painting during the process of painting. I will bring you more wonderful content. Stay tuned.